Hello, hello, and welcome back to Space Engineers on the Xbox, on the Series X, and this particular tutorial is all about hydrogen. I've seen a few people elsewhere and on the Facebook group talk and ask questions about hydrogen and so on and so forth, so I thought I'd better revisit hydrogen and show you couple of things about hydrogen as your fuel source and your thrusters. It is, without mods, the strongest thrust that you're going to get in the game, and we're going to take a look at some things about it. So starting off, we're going to need a few things on my little test platform. You might also notice there's lots of red. This is because I have the Faction Wars mod installed, which I will be looking at a little later on in a mod showcase. And it's a way, without scripts and so on, to drop in a lot more encounters in your Space Engineers game. A lot more, if you look. There's a lot of encounters out there for those potentially hungry to test out their weapons against enemy factions. And also, Faction Wars allows you to join said factions and so on. There's a few other things as well, but I'll go over that when I talk about the mod in detail. This is hydrogen. One large hydrogen tank. We're running in creative to save time and trouble, and this one large hydrogen tank here will start out at 50% and it won't fill beyond that. In addition to this large hydrogen tank, we're going to throw on one of these. We're going to change its content to script. There are scripts built into Space Engineers, but they are simple ones for various things, and you want the energy and hydrogen right there. So we have 50%. What we're going to need as well is a way to control this particular demonstration / experiment. So we're going to throw on we'll use one of these, control station, and we're going to need something to control. We're going to start with one large grid hydrogen thruster. And we'll move on from there. So we'll just stick this large grid onto our control, push up on the D-pad, and look for your large grid hydrogen thruster, and just put toggle block on off. And you can see, there it is. Our hydrogen, as you can see, is sitting at 50%. If we fire up that thruster at the moment, it's on idle, so not much is going to happen. So what we want to do is go to this thruster, and we want to go down to this large hydrogen thruster. We want to go to thrust override, and we want to hold both shoulder buttons and tap the right D-pad direction twice, which will give us full thrust. Now when we put full thrust on, we're going to start using hydrogen. And we're going to use it fairly quickly. not as quick as it used to be, because Keen did a hydrogen rebalance a good few patches and updates ago, which changed hydrogen for the better, both in terms of ship fuel and even the hydrogen generators. Those are actually worthwhile now for charging batteries and things like that. They're not great for a power source for your base. They're best used still as quick charge. But there is your hydrogen. So one large hydrogen thruster and that hydrogen brings us down to 48.1%. We are going to add an O2 H2 generator to the mix. Just one to begin with. You'll see that it starts to fill the tank again, the numbers going up. If we punch the full thrust on one of these, you'll see, if we look in here, but our number is still going up. So one O2 H2 generator, one large tank, and one hydrogen thruster large grid will give us a positive inflow of hydrogen fuel into this system as we are using it and at full thrust, which means that if you've got one of these, that this tank and a cockpit on it, and you shoot yourself off a planet into space, you're going to get there. You're not going to be able to get back, probably, unless you reverse the whole thing and just plummet into the ground and stick a parachute on it. But we are there. So if we add to this mix, and we'll just let the hydrogen fill up, another large hydrogen thruster, conveniently on the side here. And we don't need to worry about anything. We'll just over here again, just make sure they're both, you can see one is on, one is off. Easy enough to fix, like so. Make sure we've got them both selected. Make a group out of them. Save it off. Get rid of this old thing by pushing up on the D-pad, then pressing X. Then making ourselves a new group with the direction held on the D-pad. Then pressing the hydrogen thrusters, turning them to turn on and off. Now we've got positive hydrogen flow, but now we've got two thrusters and one O2 H2 generator. So if I turn these two thrusters up at full with one hydrogen tank, you're looking that this number will now rapidly go down. Like, we are losing fuel. Again, not too bad. But if I'm just using one of these generators and I decide that I'm going to go for like a big set of thrusters because I need some good lift and one tank, if I put five of these thrusters, you might guess what's going to happen. We're going to drain that hydrogen tank like mad. If we want a positive influx of, or inflow of fuel to this system, we add more generators. And you'll see with two engines and two generators, that number is going up again. Now you can guess what's going to happen if I add a third large hydro thruster here and then just go to its setting, slap it on thrust override. You might have noticed that the number is falling again. So you can tell that every large hydrogen thruster and every large hydrogen tank on a system like this correlates to one generator per large hydrogen thruster. So, for example, if I'm building another rig of thrusters, if you hear banging, by the way, my cat is back, one of the seven. He's playing with his toys. As Mal, my old cat, used to help me before he passed away with Space Engineers, Jasper, the spitting image of Mal, is carrying on with that tradition. And as we come down here, we're going to put that one on. And we're going to put that one on. So now we have five large grid hydrogen thrusters, but only two generators pushing fuel into this system. And if you look at our control panel, that number is rolling down quite quickly. It won't be long before that tank is empty. Now, as the rule states, if we add one, two, three more of these to this system, with these on full burn, you'll notice the number is now starting to climb. So when you're building a ship and you're using hydrogen, you have to try and work out how many thrusters worth of fuel can be offset by hydrogen generators, because yes, you're going to get a lot more weight from a hydrogen generator, but on the other hand, you are going to get a positive inflow or influx of hydrogen. So with that in mind, I always like to double the generators per large tank on small ships. If you've noticed, I'll do two or three and I can get to space quite happily and back on a full tank of fuel. And most of the time when I'm coasting in space using the inertial dampeners, I'm gaining fuel back as long as there's ice in the system. So if we take this particular system here and we just decide that we are going to come off it. Two, three, four, five. Might not be pretty. Five more of these. And our number is going up rapidly. Even though there are five large hydrogen thrusters pouring, you know, thrust and fuel out of the system, our hydrogen generators are putting fuel in back faster than the system can use it. So if you work out that one hydrogen gen can support one large grid thruster with one large hydrogen tank, you can then make a ship that is fuel efficient. Because a lot of people just slap thrusters on a ship until it gets lift. You can use an online calculator, work out the mass of your ship, work out its weight, and actually, I don't need to bother with that because I'm just turn it all off. You can basically then use the online calculator, and I'll leave a link to the one I tend to use in the description of this video when I'm done, and I upload it onto YouTube to work out exactly how many thrusters you need to get a ship like, say, the Red Ship off the ground in Grav. If you look at our little thing, it's now on 65% full, and fuel is still coming into that system. If I added another 5 to 10 O2 generators along this, it would rapidly fill. So this also answers the question, how many O2 generators does it take to fill one large hydrogen tank? And the answer to that is that when the thrusters aren't being used, I would personally put 2, 4, 5 onto that. You could build a closed set of generators that specifically fill tanks. You can put tanks onto stockpile. The main thing, though, with space engineers is not to get frustrated with it, because it is a difficult game. The learning curve on this is rapid. It's quite high. There are certain systems, like making these airlocks, which could get simpler down the line as space engineers evolves. We are going to see grid AI, and you know, we don't know exactly what's coming with that. But to start with, just experiment with things like this. Build yourself a few test rigs. Build yourself a brick of a ship. Save the game. Hold down both bumpers, tap X, press A, save it, and then play around with it. If it blows up, reload the save. You don't need to quit to the main menu to do that. You hold down the right bumper, go into admin mode, and then go down to replay tool. Then you'll see the option to reload the world. If you click on that, it'll reload your last save. And there you have it. Just have fun with the game. And you can look at my channel. For the last 2+ years, I've been putting Xbox-focused Space Engineers content onto this channel at a fairly regular rate, either on a Sunday or a Tuesday, depending on what's going on around and what my workload is. And basically, anything you want, you can find for the Xbox on my channel, barring online stuff to do with scripts and to do with other aspects of the game that require you playing on servers. I don't do that because I don't really have time to jump onto servers and do tutorials on the programmable block, etc. I don't do scripting. There are other people who do that, and we have a very limited amount of resources when it comes to the Xbox with the scripted mods anyway. We can only use what are called server-side scripts. We can't use client-side scripts, so we can't get the shields and other such mods on console that work yet. That's all going to change, though, probably, over time. Keen may even adopt a brand new scripting, but as I've been waffling on, you can see our tank is now at 100%. We're still firing 5 of these large grids off, and the system will now let this ship, if it was a ship, quite happily fly about without any problem, as long as there's ice on board generating fuel. And that's my 101 about hydrogen based fuel systems, how many generators are required to effectively fill a large grid, single tank, when it's got five thrusters pouring off it. And remember, if you've got 10 of these large grid thrusters, then you'll need 10 of those generators to support fuel going back into this tank. 20 generators, really, if you want to make a system like that. You can get away with half the amount, but you are going to use fuel. And the idea is to use as little fuel as possible or get a net gain of fuel. But that's about it from me. Hopefully this is useful to somebody. Please feel free to reach out in the comments of the video and, of course, on the community tab, as well as the Facebook group and the Discord. You can find those off the community tab. And yeah, hopefully you've enjoyed it. That's about all I can think to say, apart from my usual, stay safe, take care, have fun, enjoy the game. Again, lots more content from me coming down the line, and I will definitely see you in the next one. Bye for now.